Once your print has completed, it's time to post-process your part. Since liquid resin still clings to the printed part when completed, you must wash them in a solvent to remove the excess resin. Once clean and dry, a post-cure step will ensure the part reaches its final mechanical properties and is ready to use. This video will show you how to process Form 4 and Form 4L prints using the Form Wash 2nd Generation, Form Wash L 2nd Generation, and the Form Cure and Form Cure L. Please refer to our support articles if you will be using alternate post-processing solutions that Formlabs provides. Note that the Form 4 and Form 4L build platforms are not compatible with the original Form Wash or Form Wash L build platform mounts. The Form Wash 2nd Generation can hold up to 15 liters of solvent, and the Form Wash L can hold up to 38 liters of solvent, though they can be run with less. We recommend using 90% or higher purity isopropyl alcohol. Please note, for the Form 4B and Form 4BL, all biocompatible parts must be washed using 99% IPA and cannot be washed with alternate solutions. Refer to the manufacturing guide or instructions for use for your resin to find the best solution for your specific application. Always wear non-reactive nitrile gloves when interacting with liquid resin. Wear safety glasses when removing support structures during post-processing. Using the knob on the Form Wash or the touchscreen on the Form Wash L, navigate the display menu and choose Raise to lift the mount and basket out of the unit. You can move the build platform mount arms up or down depending on the size of your part and the level of solvent in your unit. Once you have the arms in the preferred position, slide your build platform onto the mount arms. The Form Wash and Form Wash L have several preset wash times to choose from in the navigation menu. Quick, a 1-minute wash, short, a 5-minute wash, default, a 10-minute wash, and long, a 20-minute wash. There's also an option to set a custom wash time. Wash times for different resins vary. For parts being used for biocompatible applications, always refer to the materials manufacturing guide or instructions for use for the recommended wash time. Once you've selected your wash time, select Start to begin the wash cycle. The build platform or basket automatically lowers down and an impeller spins to agitate the solvent. Once the cycle is complete, the build platform mount raises to ensure your part is not left soaking in solvent for too long after the end of the cycle. You can also raise the mount mid-cycle by selecting Pause. After washing, check over your part for any areas that may need additional attention. Small cavities and channels can hide resin and may need manual flushing with IPA or a second wash cycle to get fully clean. You can also remove parts from the build platform first and place them in the wire basket of the Form Wash or Form Wash L for the wash step. This is helpful if you need immediate use of your build platform for your next print. To remove parts from the build platform, either pre-wash or post-wash, use the tools provided with your unit. Mount your build platform onto the build platform jig for stability. Using the part removal tool, lift the edges of the raft to get the tool underneath. If you're finding it difficult to lift the raft, try using the flush cutters to start. By placing the flat side of the cutters against the surface of the build platform, you can squeeze the tool to slide the cutters underneath the raft. Try this at multiple points on the part until you are able to slide the removal tool underneath or the part releases from the surface. Once you have the part release tool under the raft, keep sliding it around until the seal of the raft is broken and remove your part. If you are using Build Platform Flex, no tools are needed. Simply press on the handles to pop up the surface of the platform to break the seal and release your part. Post-curing with solvent still present on your parts may cause part finish issues. Once fully dry, your part is ready to be post-cured in the Form Cure or Form Cure L. This process exposes your printed parts to consistent heat and UV light to bring them to their peak mechanical properties in just the click of a button. You can choose to leave the support structures on or remove them prior to the post-cure step. Leaving support structures on can keep thin parts from warping, but could also make the support structures more difficult to remove. Partial removal of some supports can provide stability while also allowing enough light to cure areas that may be blocked by denser support structures. Place your part in the Form Cure or Form Cure L and use the knob to select the appropriate time and temperature setting. These settings will vary per resin. Refer to the Formlabs support article on cure times for the most current recommendations. Cure times are anywhere from 5 minutes to 60 minutes and can use no heat or up to 80 degrees Celsius. Always place the part in the form cure or form curel at the start of the cycle so that the part heats up with the unit. Once your post-cure step is complete, your part may be hot. Use caution when removing from the unit and consider giving it a little time to cool down before handling. When you're ready to remove support structures, Formlabs Light Touch Supports lets you separate your parts from the structures easily. Make sure to wear safety glasses during this step. Grip your part in one hand and the raft with the other and separate them using a twisting motion. If you find this difficult, use the flush cutters to free some of the support points to make the separation easier. Once the structures are removed, examine your part and use the flush cutters to remove any supports that may not have separated cleanly. The flat part of the flush cutters should sit against your part when cutting. Always point sharp tools away from your body for safety. By washing, drying, post-curing, and removing support structures, you've finished the basic post-processing steps and your part is now ready for use. Depending on the end use of your print, you may wish to go into more advanced steps such as sanding, buffing, painting, or polishing, and thermoforming for biocompatible parts. Formlabs finishing toolkits are available in our online store, and articles about advanced post-processing can be found on our support site.